Okay, I mean, first let me say that I'm very esteemed to be part of this panel and have tremendous respect for all the people who spoke before you. So I'm a member of, before me, I'm a member of Witness Against Torture. It's a group that's been working since 2005 to close Guantanamo and end torture. And the first thing I want to say is that I represent here the citizen voice. All too often, the torture saga is presented as a narrow beltway drama pitting the executive versus the courts, or Congress versus the executive, or Senate Democrats versus Senate Republicans, or even the Pentagon versus the president. But the issue far transcends partisanship or the distribution of power among branches. It speaks rather to the soul of the nation. And I want to say here today that there are millions of Americans who remain absolutely sick at heart at the unimpeachable fact that America tortured. And we remain disturbed and saddened that there has been nothing close to an adequate national reckoning with the country's grave crimes. Time itself does not heal this wound, and we have not let it go. Why should we? Now to the torture report. When it became clear that the United States abused detainees, there should have been investigations, indictments, and prosecutions to assign legal culpability. That's what the rule of law demands. It's the most powerful deterrent for such behavior happening again. But as the other panelists have said, Obama made the fateful decision not to pursue such action, in essence granting the Bush administration the power to rewrite laws to its own sinister ends. So we don't have on this issue the power and prestige of the law. There's been no accountability for perpetrators. There's been no justice for or apology to the victims. But we have at least one crucially and vitally important thing, the torture report. Its function is to burnish into the public record and the consciousness of the nation the sordid fact that America tortured, so that no one of any responsibility can either deny that it happened or claim that it worked. At least we can have the deterrence of this narrative. And then McCain and Feinstein in their introductions, you know, all but said this, that this is a kind of prophylaxis via storytelling in lieu of the law to prevent America from going down that dangerous path again. It took an act of courage to write the report. It took an act of courage to release the executive summary. And sadly, given the partisan climate, it will take an act of some courage to now do the right thing and release the full report, to again scream the facts that so many, including our new president, refuse to hear. Now more than ever, we need to affirm that torture happened, that it was ugly, that it can never happen again. And if it does, there should be real consequences. Now I want to close with a tragic, close with a comment more as a historian than an activist. I'm a professional historian. I teach at the New School in New York City. I find it tragic, infuriating, and ludicrous that there has been such entrenched opposition inside our government to releasing the full report. Manipulating and erasing the past is the stuff of fascists, totalitarians, and teapot dictators, not a proud democracy. It's time, as we have all said, for America to act in a way worthy of its own creed, you know, come clean about its own past and permit the democratic public, you know, the facts that allow it to make decisions in accord with the exercise of moral reason. That's what democracy is all about. And denying or hiding your own, you know, history is craven and dangerous, and we won't stand for it. Thank you.